All right, this is Pastor Jim with Real Life Church here today to do another installment of our Homeschool for the Soul. Today I'm talking to my friend Marcos, who works with Compassion International, and he's going to talk to us a little bit about the great ministries he's involved in, and he's going to share with us some ways we can be involved in those ministries as well. Hey, Marcos, how you doing?
Doing good. Yeah, hanging in there, going a little stir crazy, you know, COVID.
Yep, you and everybody else, yeah. I got out. I went to the church today. I'm in front of this ominous cross with this lighting back here.
Oh, that's so good. You're a wise man, because I have 4 kids under 8 that are in the house, and they're all being quarantined within the quarantine of our house, the other room. So if they break in here, I just forewarning.
That's okay. That'll just add to the
interview's going south real fast. Come on.
So, Marcos, you're tell me your title with Compassion. You're the West Coast representative? Is that what it is?
Yes, yeah, church relations manager out here for Southern California. So let's get that.
Okay, Southern California.
So I've been doing it for 4 years, and it's been great serving the church in this way abroad, but then also here locally, SoCal.
Yeah, and Marcos and I have had some good coffees together and actually went on a little trip to the Philippines together a couple of years ago.
That's right, where you sponsored your little child from.
That's right. Let's go. That's right. That's what we're going to talk about today. A lot of real life church knows who Compassion is, but there's always new folks checking us out. So for those who don't know, for those who've never heard of Compassion International before, give us an intro.
Yeah, for sure. So Compassion is all about releasing children from poverty. This is what I really love too, in the name of Jesus. So it's just this great holistic work that is approaching the child in a holistic way, right? Where it's like, yeah, we want to care for the child's spiritual needs, but we also want to feed the child. We also want to make sure that they're receiving a great education so that this cycle of poverty can be broken. And so we've been doing that since 1952 through a pastor that started the work from the south side of Chicago, my hometown, my area. And he started in Korea during the Korean War. And he went out there and hasn't looked back. And so my wife's Korean, I'm from Chicago, so it was destined that I'd be a part of this great ministry that's releasing children from poverty in the name of Jesus. And here's the one of the things that I'll break down a little bit further is that, so we're child focused, we're Christ-centered, and we're church-based. So a lot of what we're doing is exclusively through a local church. Right. And that's huge for us because it's all about the local church on the ground being the hero as they point to Christ, the ultimate hero. So I love it. You know, kids are being reached and discipled, and their families are being reached as well. And so, and it's all through the hands and feet and hearts of local people loving them from a local church. So,
That's great. And I can say from a first person perspective, it's a lot of fun. It works on your heart in good ways. So like you said, I met this little girl, Princess Anne, when I was over in there in the Philippines, and she needed a sponsor. So my family started sponsoring her, and her picture's on our refrigerator. And I write letters back and forth actually with her mom. And we write pretty often. Every you know, couple months we'll send letters back and forth. So I get updates on their family and how they're doing. And it's neat to do. And I know that as we give to that ministry, she's getting schooling, she's getting food and clothes, she's getting Bible study. We met kids when we were over there who were in college because Compassion had helped them work out of extreme poverty and into college education.
That's right. Yeah. So not only is it holistic, right? But we're working with mothers that are pregnant. So we're saying prenatal all the way up until the child gets to college, that we want to see them advance and flourish, right? To the point that they have the option to go to college. And, you know, and the reality is when you get that type of attention and care from a local church, a lot of these kids, not only are they saying yes to Jesus, right? They're also saying yes to the call that God has on their lives. So this call could be, hey, I want you to be an engineer and represent me in that space. Be salt and light there. I want you to be a doctor and represent me there. And you know what? A lot of them are also getting the call to be missionaries themselves or pastors. And so they're returning and they want to give to their community what they were given, right, through a local church. So it's a beautiful thing. And I have to say this. Look, lot of the focus, rightfully so, is on the blessing that's raining down on these communities, abject poverty, and how cycles are being broken. But the reality is that there is a reciprocity to that. The blessing comes right back to our homes in Glendora, all of the places in Southern California where we're in relationship with a child. And like you said, with even the mom, like that blessing is coming back and it's transformative. And so I love how this discipleship, really it's a model of discipleship that we have at Compassion, is discipling both believers, the child, her mom, but also, Jim, you're being discipled context of the Philippines, right? And by this child specifically and her mom.
Yes. Yeah. So Real Life is doing a little bit of an invitation right now. We know that people are in hard situations. Some people have lost their jobs and are in tight situations themselves. But some of us are in a situation where we're employed and we still want to be generous. We still want to follow God's calling on our lives. We still want to care for people who are in even harder situations than we are, because in addition to the virus and the lockdown, they were already living in poverty. So it's so much more dangerous for them that we want to continue to care for them. So we're trying to pass out an invitation to our church and beyond to say, hey, now might be a good time to sponsor a child with Compassion. Mm-hmm. And we've got a couple different ways digitally that we can do that, right?
Yeah, that's right. So if you text LOVE, doesn't have to be capitalized on the L, feel free to do so. But if you text LOVE, though, to 83393, we will send you a child. And this is worldwide. It could be from the Philippines, like where your child is from, Jim, or it could be El Salvador, wherever. But you'll get a text response back with a child to sponsor. So feel free to go ahead and follow through on filling out all the information for that child.
Yeah. And likewise, if you go to reallife.la, which is our website, you'll find a list of kids. You can actually browse through their pictures and pick the child you want to sponsor. reallife.la/compassion. If you go to reallife.la/compassion, that's all up and live right now. And you can click over there and find a kid that you want to sponsor. Write letters back and forth. Watch them grow up. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah. Go Real Life. Let's go.
Yeah, well, I appreciate you walking us through this so we can get a better view of what it is and how it works. And I love it. I've been sponsoring kids with Compassion for better than 20 years, which is amazing because I'm only 25. So to be for so long.
That's right. Oh, my gosh.
Pastor should tell the truth.
Yeah. Hey, can I just drop this on you, too? You know, just we were projected to see 70,000 kids sponsored when COVID this whole thing hit. We had, what was like March until June. We were, Compassion for All the U.S. was saying, hey, we're projecting commitments coming in at 70,000 kids. And all of that got washed away. And we have a pool now that's been inflated to 250,000 kids that are currently needing a sponsor. When you think of that, you know, the need is really great. And I know it can seem overwhelming, and it's not to overwhelm all of our listeners here, but it's to say, like, to your point, you know, we've been hit hard for sure. No doubt. 100%. We acknowledge that. But also there's this reality that kids in abject poverty and their families have been hit super hard, and we can make a difference. Right. And so don't be intimidated by the numbers, but be influenced by what God is moving us to do on an individual level.
Yeah, that is good to know, that you would have normally sponsored another 70,000, and because of the dire situation, the need has grown while the number of people sponsoring has dropped. And so those are huge numbers, and it's important to think about those huge numbers, and also just the fact that there is one kid out there right now who needs somebody. Yeah. And if anybody's tuning in and watching this video, there's one kid out there right now who needs you. And for how much is it a month? What do they send them?
$38 a month.
$38 a month. You can revolutionize this kid's life. You can change this kid's life for good, for the rest of their lives.
Yeah, absolutely.
And so I hope God does lay that on a few hearts today. Anybody who comes across this video, I hope you pray over that.
Yeah. One, and I'll lead with an encouragement thing that we're seeing is that, you know, we thought that maybe the drop rate would go significantly up. And actually, it's still holding in terms of people staying on and committed to sponsoring their children. I think people get it. I think people understand, like, yeah, we've been hit hard, but these kids are in a harder place. How can you social distance in the slums, and how can you quarantine, all these things? And so we've been pretty encouraged at Compassion to see our sponsors stay with their children. So yeah, that's amazing.
That's got it work in people's hearts.
Yes, that's right.
Awesome. Well, Marcos, thank you. I appreciate your time today. Appreciate you walking us into this. Look forward to the effects it has and the good things that we get to do in the world together.
Sounds great.
Bless you today, brother.
Bless you.